So what I'm going to do in my 8 minutes is to, in five acts, review the work I've been doing for the last 30 years and then project forward to the work I'm going to do for the next 30 years and an epilogue. Act one is common sense and common nonsense. If I were to ask, what do you need to be successful at any time? The answer from common sense would be, you need wit, you need to be smart. And the way we know how smart somebody is we see how good their brain is, how good the computer is inside their head. And you need grit. You've got to work hard and persevere, as athletes and artists and anybody who does a lot of training needs to do. But one goal of social science, and most of us here that spoke with you today are social scientists, is to transcend common sense when it is instead common nonsense. That's a word that my own teacher, Nelson Goodman, who founded Project Zero, coined. And so today we're going to re-examine wit and grit. Act two is wit pluralized. 30 years ago, when I and others looked at the data from different cultures, different historical eras, what goes on in different parts of the brain, we determined that wit is better thought of as pluralized in terms of a number of relatively independent computers, which we call the multiple intelligences. And those computers compute language, this is Emily Dickinson, mathematics and logic, music, spatial information, bodily kinesthetic problem solving, understanding of other people, understanding of yourself, and the ability to make discriminations in the world of nature. All of us can do all these things, but there's no reason to think that being good in one predicts being good or bad in any other one. So what we did, what I did, was to pluralize the word intelligence, to make it multiple intelligences, and then, and I'm very humbled by this, the idea spread very widely. Act three is the rise of grit. In many educational environments today, there's a move beyond wit or wits to look at what Jim Heckman, the Nobel laureate, calls non-cognitive skills. Social skills, EQ, empathy, the ability to reflect and wonder. And there's a star in this galaxy, and that's grit, glittering grit. How many of you have heard recently about grit? Okay, well, if you listen to Angela Duckworth, who teaches at Penn, or you read Paul Tough's book, How Children Succeed, you would learn about the importance of grit. And I love grit. I like it in everybody I know. It sounds great, but Act Four is on the limits of grit and of wits. These folks had lots of grit, these soldiers marching in step in Nazi Germany. No absence of grit whatsoever. An event that happened to me brought me short in thinking about my own theory. About 20 years ago, I learned that a whole state in Australia was using the theory of multiple intelligences, and I was very excited until I learned that one of the curricular edicts was a list of all the racial and ethnic groups in this state and which intelligence it had and which ones it lacked. And I realized that you throw a meme, a unit of meaning to the world, and you really don't know what kind of use people will make of it, whether it's a wit kind of meme or a grit kind of meme. Two books that may be known to people, The Best and the Brightest, a book about the Vietnam War by David Halberstam, The Smartest Guys in the Room, a book about Enron. These books are ironic references to wit and grit, because the folks who went to Enron, the folks who went to Washington to prosecute the Vietnam War, and we have to say a lot of them came from Harvard, had plenty of wit, plenty of grit, but it was not sufficient. So Act Five presents the goods. What I believe, and I've been working with colleagues on this for a long time, is grit and wit are not enough. They have to be directed to becoming a good person, a good worker, and a good citizen. Now, about good persons, this is something we've known about for millennia. And if you follow the Golden Rule or the Ten Commandments or other religious or historic texts, that tells you how to be a good person, what to do and what not to do. But work and citizenship are more complicated. Basically, this isn't something that people have known how to do for thousands of years. Rather, different professions have developed over the last decades or centuries, and citizenship is really a concept for democratic societies where people have some say of what's going on in their community, the nation, and the planet. So what does it mean to do good work or good citizen? We spent 10 years analyzing this. The answer, which took a long time to arrive at, is there's a triple helix of good work and good citizenship. In English, they all begin with the letter E: excellence, ethics, and engagement. A good teacher, who is a good professional, knows a lot, he or she is excellent, is engaged, cares, and ethically tries to do things the right way, which is especially important when situations are complicated and you can't just, quote unquote, look it up. We developed something called the Good Project, which now has different strands: good work, good play. You can read it as well as I can. Where's poorly, good citizenship, good life, good collaboration. And there we try to analyze the steps which you might need to take if you want to use wit and grit in these positive directions. We've developed a good work toolkit, which is used in professionals, high school, college, even now in earlier education, where teachers and other people who work with young people can try to develop those muscles of wit and grit. We also have a website funded by somebody in this room, thank you, Susan, called Multiple Intelligence's Oasis. The image is a source of nourishment in the middle of a big desert where we talk of some of the good and not so good ways to use MI ideas. I mentioned earlier this book, Multiple Intelligences Around the World. One of the chapters comes from a wonderful school in the Philippines called the Multiple Intelligence International School. The kids there not only have an opportunity to develop their MIs, but to put them to the use of the wider community. And this is an essay written by Joy Aviquin, who is the founding director of that school. And she talks here about how we can use our intelligence to make a difference under the title, MI Does Good Work. I promised you an epilogue if you don't have 8 minutes, but only 8 seconds. And that's a tweet. And here's the tweet: multiple wits, good grit, at all ages and around the world. Thank you.